Hello everyone, this is Abdu Alkishe, postdoctoral at Department of Fish and Wildlife Conservation at Virginia Tech. I'm going to talk today about environmental data sources and considerations. So what will you gain from this lecture is knowing some environmental variables, the methods we got method that used to get those environmental variables, and I'll give you an example about environmental variables and the difference between each one and how to deal with multi-collinearity. So here some examples of the environmental variables. This is not all of them, it is just the most common ones. And we have a lot more than this, but this is what we mostly use in ecological niche modeling. How to collect those data? There are a lot of different methods, starting with on the ground, with a surface station, upper air station, weather radar, satellite ground station, using aircraft or polar orbiting satellite, or on the sea, like weather ships, and other methods. So here, there are like a lot of environmental data sources, but what I'm showing here, the most common ones, I start with WorldClim, and AmeriClim, and also CHILSA. We have other examples, but again, these are the most common environmental data sources. And these are the data explanation from WorldClim database. And you see here with the 19 environmental variables, from the bio one, which is the annual mean temperature, to bio 11. Those are just for temperature. And from bio 12 and to the bio 19, those are for the precipitation. Here is the example for WorldClim. So this data came from weather station. The data is from 1970 to 2000, and it's available with a 4 spatial resolution between 30 second to 10 minutes arc. And in this example, the data is under 10 minutes resolution. And as you see, it's manual or mean annual temperature and mean annual precipitation by 12. So here we don't have a data on the sea, as I mentioned, because we have weather stations. So with the next example, which is AmeriClim, and this is came from satellite image, and you see we have a data all around the sea, oceans, and ground, and this data available under 3 period of time from 1980s, 1990s, and 2000s. And you can find a 3 spatial resolution from 2.5 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes arc. Here is the example of environmental layers. As you see, we have a 2.5 minutes resolution, which is a very fine resolution. 5 minutes and 10 minutes, which is the coarse or the largest resolution. And here is like using a bio, different bio 1 to bio 7 and bio 10 and bio 11. And these are like temperature variables. And the blue one is for a humidity variables. So the example or the difference between world claim and the mirror claim beside including the values on the ocean, in mirror claim they use a humidity variables, but in world claim use precipitation variables. How to deal with the variables? It's very important to figure out which variable you want to use, and then cropping and masking and resampling your variables on the area of interest. And you have to deal after that with multicollinearity, which is to figure out which variable is correlated with another variable. And to manage that, there are different ways. One of them is creating correlation matrix. The other one is principal component analysis. And there are other methods. So in this case, with anthrax, for example, this paper was created by Daniel Romero, and he used one temperature variable after running principal component analysis or creating correlation matrix. For example, here, as you see, he ran the analysis and found out some correlation. For example, the bio 1, as you see, correlated with bio 5, bio 6 in red boxes, and bio 8, 9, 10, and 11. So with this one is bio 1 has a lot of correlation with different variables, but bio 5, bio 6 have also bio 8 and bio 10 have the same correlation with bio 11. So in this way, we can take or get an idea about which variable is correlated with another one, and we choose one of those variables. The other way is to use a principal component analysis. This analysis is a dimensionality reduction method that's often used to reduce the dimensionality of large data sets. And here, as you see, creating or selected threshold of example, for example, here 90% of variation. So in this case, he got the first three principal components with 95% of variance. So the other methods here, for example, in those papers, they use the variance inflation factor and jackknife via maxent. So if you are interested more in those methods, you can like read about in those papers. But the most common methods are principal component analysis and create a correlation matrix. So the take home exam is we have multiple sources for variable to explore, and you need to know your system. It's very important to choose your variables that corresponding and giving more realistic details about your system or your species. Avoid multicollinearity. It's not good for your models. You have to do some work in doing any option from running principal component analysis or other methods, and you have to report your raster variables and take care of creating the best raster variables for your models. In the end, thank you so much for your listening.